morning children. In the last class we studied the lesson Ancient Cities of Tamilagam in History Unit 4. In that we studied about the city Pumbukar. Now let us go to study the city Madurai in Tamilagam. Is it clear children? Madurai. Madurai has been one of the oldest cities in India. Its antiquity can be understood from the sobriquet Sangam Valartha Nagaram. Madurai is also called Sangam Valartha Nagaram. Pandyas, the Cholas and later the Kalabras ruled Madurai in the ancient period. We know Pandyas, Cholas, they were all ruled this Madurai in the ancient period. And during medieval times, later Cholas and later Pandyas and after that Nayak also ruled this historic city. So that there was a cultural blending, cultural mixing in this city. Trade has developed and evidence for this has been unearthed in archaeological excavation done in Kiradi near Madurai. You would have seen in TV in recent days, there was a news about Kiradi. The archaeological department unearthed so many things from that place. These are all the evidences for that ancient Madurai. Is it clear, children? Madurai is proudly associated with Tamil Sangam. What is called Sangam? You would have studied last year itself. Sangam is a group of people. Okay, association of people. Okay, which work for the promotion of Tamil language. Why they made this Sangam? There were so many poets in Tamil. They all joined together to develop the language Tamil. Okay, for that reason only they formed this Sangam. 49 poets were associated with the last Sangam. How many poets? 49 poets. Ahil, fragrant wood, was brought from the port Tondi to Madurai. King Solomon of ancient Israel imported pearls from Uvari. This Uvari is near the Pandyan port Kurkai. Okay. A mint of Roman coins was present at Madurai. Roman coins were produced in Madurai on those times. Such a famous place, Madurai. Not only Roman coins, the coins of other countries also minted at Madurai. Okay. So these are all the proof of glory of the place Madurai. The famous of Madurai is attested by the accounts of the Greek historian Megasthenes. You would have studied about this traveler Megasthenes in 5th standard itself. He wrote about Madurai in his book Indica. And also Chanakya, he was a minister of Chandragupta king. He also wrote about Madurai in his book Arthashastra. In the moat around the town, do you know what is a moat? Moat is water which is surrounded by the town. The entire city was surrounded by water. That is called moat. Tunnels had been constructed in such a way that even elephants could comfortably enter. In between the moats, they made tunnels. The tunnels was such a big one so that the elephants also could enter easily. Okay. This was the story of the ancient Madurai. Now, we go to see why Madurai was called Thunga Nagaram. On those time, Madurai had two markets. One was called Nalangadi, the other one was called Alangadi. What is Nalangadi? The day market. The daytime market was called Nalangadi. The evening time market was called Alangadi. Do you understand, children? There were two types of market in those times in Madurai. One is called Nalangadi, The other one is called Alangadi. Madurai is known as Thunga Nagaram. Why it was called Thunga Nagaram? All the 24 hours it will be busy. It never sleeps. The city never sleeps. So that it was called Thunga Nagaram. Madurai was a safe place where women purchased the things from Alangadi without any fear. That's all about the city Madurai. Let us go to study about the next city, Kanchi. Children, when we talk about school, what would you say? School is a place for learning, isn't it? A place of learning is called school. Several schools were established in the city Kanchipuram. Jain schools were called Jainapalli. In that Jainapalli, the Jain students will be studied. Same like that, the Buddhists all studied in Viharas. Their school was called Viharas. The greatness of Kanchi as an educational center can be understood from the fact that the Chinese traveler Yuan Xuang, who studied at Nalanda University, visited Kanchi Kadigai to pursue his further studies. In last class, you would have studied about the Chinese traveler Yuan Xuang. He came to India. He was studying in Nalanda University. After that, he came to Kanchi. He started doing his higher studies in Kanchi Kadigai. Okay, from this you can understand how Kanchipuram was famous for education. Is it clear, children? The poet Kalidasa says, Kanchi is the best of the towns. The other Tamil poet saint Thirunavukkarasar says about Kanchi as Kalviyil Karayillada Kanchi. Is it clear? Yuan Xuang remarked that Kanchi can be counted as one among the seven sacred places like Buddh Gaya and Sanchi. Kanchi is the oldest town in Tondai Nadu. It is the oldest town in Tondai Nadu. The great scholars, who are all? Dharmabalar, Jyothibalar, Sumadhi and Bodhidharmar, all were born in this city, Kanchi only. Kanchi is also known as the temple town. Why it is called temple town? Because there were lot of temples in Kanchipuram. The famous temple of great architectural beauty, Kailasanatha temple. It was built by later Pallava king Rajasimha at Kanchi. During this Pallava period, a large number of cave temples also were built. The Buddhist monk, who was that Buddhist monk? Manimegalai. Who is this Manimegalai? In Silapadigaram, this character coming. Do you remember? She spent her last part of her lifetime in Kanchi. Okay. Such a great city, Kanchi. Water management played an important role in the agrarian society of those times. Hundreds of lakes were created for storing water around the town of Kanchi. There were so many lakes they formed to store water in Kanchi. These lakes were well connected with canals. All these lakes were interconnected with canals. During the later period, Kanchi came to be known as the District of Lakes. Why it was called the District of Lakes? Because there were so many lakes in Kanchi. Water management skills of the ancient Tamils can be understood from the construction of Kallanai. The great Kallanai. Who built this Kallanai? You know that, no? The great Chola king Karikalan. He only built that Kallanai in the Chola country and the lakes and canals in Kanchi. Okay, have you understood about Kanchi, the greatness of Kanchi, children? Apart from Bhumbukar, Madurai and Kanchi, there were other towns too in ancient Tamilagam. They are Korkai, Vanchi, Tondi, உறையூர், முசிறி, கருவூர், மாமல்லபுரம், தஞ்சை, தகடூர் அண்ட் கயல் ஆர் சம் ஆஃப் தெம். பை கண்டக்டிங் ஆர்கியோலாஜிக்கல் ரிசர்ச் வி கேன் கம் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் மோர் அபவுட் திஸ் பிளேசஸ். தட்ஸ் ஆல் அபவுட் திஸ் லெசன் சில்ட்ரன். ஃப்ரம் திஸ் லெசன் வி அண்டர்ஸ்டுட் ஒன் திங், வாட்? பூம்புக்கார் வாஸ் எ போர்ட், மதுரை வாஸ் எ ட்ரேடிங் டவுன், அண்ட் காஞ்சி வாஸ் அன் எஜுகேஷனல் சென்டர். இஸ் இட் கிளியர் சில்ட்ரன்? பை சில்ட்ரன்.